Hi, I'm Monica Bay, and I'm here at the fantastic campus here at the University of Florida. And we are here for the eDiscovery project. And I'm with Tom O'Connor, who I have known forever. Hey, when I was editor-in-chief of Law Technology News, we had the Tom O'Connor rule, which was when he was not working for a vendor, he was on the board. When he was working a vendor, he was off the board. And that changed about 20 times the course of my tenure and your tenure. So we go back a long time. How do we get the current students, especially the new students, to understand the import of eDiscovery and how technology has just changed the entire way that the law schools teach and that big law and all law is working? What's the impact of that, and how do we let people know that it's not a second class citizen anymore to be in eDiscovery? And I know, because I worked and put myself through law school being one of those third-class citizens, because I was a temp. Nobody's lower than low as a temp. So the whole terrain has changed. Tell us what the new students right now can expect and why it's so important.
That's a great question, Monica, and it's actually one I get all the time.
Really?
Yes, because people are concerned that eDiscovery is a niche, that it's a tough niche because it's associated with technical training and the one word lawyers hate to hear, math.
Oh.
So I think we have to get over that. Technology, as you and I know it, is something that's an everyday part of our life. You use the internet to make reservations, to order pizza.
Get your Yankee tickets.
To get your ball game tickets, exactly. I just reordered my Saints season tickets yesterday. It's part of where we live as a society, and as Craig Ball likes to say, it's important because it's where the evidence is.
Yes.
That's where the documents are now.
Yes.
So it's not a specialty anymore. It's part of the practice of law. The National Center for State Courts says that the number one e-discovery case type for 2 years in a row has been family law. Not big case, not complex litigation in federal courts. Family law, that's where lawyers live. So I think we have to get that word out, that it is part of the practice of law.
You know, I think you hit a really important thing, and it's the theme of the conference that we're at, really, is there's so much emphasis on these massive global cases with multi-cross-country issues and everything, and it is the everyday stuff. And one of the things that's really exploded in the last years, I would say 2 years, is how much like routine devices we have, like our phones now are mini computers. And we just heard a panel on exactly this topic on, okay, well, how do you get your content back from Facebook or from Google and with your email?
Right.
So again, focusing on the students, if they can use their phones, they can do eDiscovery.
That's right. I was really heartened, as you said, by the first panel and the second one that's going on right now about remote collections, that they are dealing with the nuts and bolts of everyday practice of law that the average practitioner will have to think about. How to collect from Gmail, how to collect from Facebook, how to drag things down and take a quick look at them. That's where everything is these days. So I think for the law students, it's important that they understand that there is the technical part of it, which you need to know, but as I like to say, when somebody objected to me once at a conference, that I don't need to know all this stuff. I said, well, you know, if you're going to do a medical malpractice case, you don't need to know how to do open heart surgery either, but you need to know the difference between a fibula and a scapula.
Perfect.
Right?
And that's a great place for us to stop. I could talk to you all day.
Right.
We're here again at the University of Florida. I'm Monica Bay. Thank you so much.
Always a pleasure to see you.
You bet.